water pollution. So nowadays we are facing a problem sometimes, water scarcity. Okay, and if we calculate, we can find out that our next generation, okay, or the generation coming, will have water scarcity. So that is why we have to look forward, okay, that we have to look after that, that there shouldn't be any water shortage or water scarcity. Or even we can reduce it by reducing the water pollution that is happening or increasing day to day. Okay, so there are some way obviously in which we can, it is in our hand only, we can reduce or we can minimize or control water pollution. Okay, so see, the water pollution caused by the industries or the power plants, we can't help it. Okay, that has to be done. The wastage they are throwing in the water, we can't control it. But the way we are polluting the water, we can at least control it, or we have to look after it, we have to check it, so that at least we can minimize or reduce the water pollution. Okay, so in our home only we can control. When we are cooking, okay, now when in the food there is lots of fat, oil, grease. So do not pour those fats or oil, grease in the sink. Okay, rather keep a container for fats that is getting out from your cooking or your food. So keep a container aside and dispose the fats, oil, grease, whatever there is in that container. When it will be full, dispose it with the solid disposals or solid garbage you have. Okay, secondly, with the minimize of pesticides or herbicides or fertilizers we are using, if we can minimize those, okay, then in some extent water pollution can be controlled. Then after, avoid using the medicals or plastics in the toilet flush. Okay, so when we are flushing it in the toilet, like tissue papers, plastics, any powder medication, any drugs, it mix up with the water, hence doing the water pollution. Okay, so avoid doing so. Keep the solid wastes different and keep the liquid waste different. Okay, and avoid using those garbage bag disposal, avoid using those. Okay, plastics, avoid using plastics as a garbage disposal. Even if you are using plastic as a garbage disposal, it is also polluting our air, not only water but also polluting our air. And when we are polluting water, our marine life or the animals in water, they are getting affected. Okay, many of them has endangered species, like, and when we are throwing something solid or plastics in water, the marine life is getting affected even. So we should reduce this water pollution. So there are many other ways which we can use to reduce the water pollution. So we need to control water pollution for our own health as well as our future generation. As well as for our future generation, they shouldn't face the water shortage or water scarcity. Okay, so for that even we need